after somebody signs up for Lucidchart, they fill out their email, password, I believe also the name, the sign up. This is loading screen. And I love it because when we chatted before we recorded, and you talked about how this is non-intrusive education. It says here, pro tip, open the Shape Library Manager by pressing the M key. Can you talk a little bit about this loading screen for Lucidchart?
Yeah, so you know we are trying to do a lot of things to help our user and want to make sure the user can have success in momenting our product ASAP. So in this whole journey, we made a few mistakes in the past, right? Like we trying to like throw education to people's face and say, these are 10 things you must know about Lucidchart that will make you extremely successful. For some people it works, right? Like for my grandma or my mom, like, they love it, right? Like, but for most like knowledge worker these days, we are familiar with technology. Mm. Like when we talk to users, some people feel offended. They feel like, like I can't do things or I can't learn myself. Like, this is so easy. Why are you telling me? Like, maybe your toy is for dummies, like not for me. Right? So like we have been getting some very spicy feedback or like tweets. So the thing my team have been striving to do is to like figuring out like how to teach and educate people in a non-intrusive way to make sure like, hey, these are going to be super helpful and people are willing to try it, but don't make them feel they are dumb or like stop them from what they are trying to get. And especially in the onboarding journey is extremely critical, right? Because people come in usually from, you know, Google search or SEO or whatever other channel, and they have something in mind. They want a value they are looking for. So if you stop them and say, hey, look at this or like hear that, they are going to just be pissed and leave. So when we do these kind of like loading screen tooltips or I wouldn't call it onboarding, but like those like helpful education type of message, we use zero stay that people have to be on this journey anyway, and you are just trying to be helpful along the way, then people love it, right? Like a lot of people is like, oh, I found this super helpful. And like when they get in, they start trying things like, and it's like very low in terms of like their cognitive low, like no one feels this is too heavy to take, but also, you know, this can be very helpful for a lot of people. And they start to see like, oh yeah, even me can use this product. And very quickly, I think there's also a magic in shortcuts, right? Like anytime when I learn a new shortcut about my Mac or any product, all of a sudden I feel, oh man, I know this better than other people. So helping people to adopting like shortcut or like these quick tips actually build up a lot more, like I will say, mental momentum than maybe the actual utility.
Interesting. I really love that whole discussion. I think we can do a whole episode on that. Can you talk a little bit about that interview? Like you said, you talked to a few users and they were offended. You said they were like so offended that you're like, oh, you think I'm so dumb? Did that really happen? Like,
that really happened. Like we talk to our user pretty regularly. Like at Lucid, we have all those mechanisms to recruit people, and some people love us. Some people kind of just like, you know, I've been loving your product for a while, but you recently did this stupid thing and pissed me off. So because, and they're always coming from the angle, it's like, because I love you so much, I'm going to tell you this type of thing. And like, I see on those calls and people just like, yeah, please stop doing this. Like, this is so stupid. Like, it's not for me. I don't need things like that.
That's really, really funny. You mentioned that. I guess it's also I know this is not part of the original questions I had shared with you, but I'm curious around how you find that balance, how you're finding that balance between, you know, being helpful and like pointing things around versus like now you're on the other end. Now it's like really annoying. Like, what did you say? It's like, you know, your mom and grandma might like that, but like for knowledge workers, they were like, be so offended that you're treating them that we're treating them so dumbly.
That's a great question, and I don't think there's a silver bullet in terms of like, oh, this is the right thing to do. Lucid is also still learning, but in general I think about a couple things, actually three. First is the audience. Second is the context. And third is the method, channel, or pattern, right? So like, I think a lot of time in most product I've seen, the way they do it is they probably only thought about one of these things and just kind of threw something in their product instead of all three. Either it's like very helpful message, but like wrong audience, or it's like something that's really cool, but like you give it in a very annoying pattern that's just, people just want to exit out whatever modal or whatever things you show them. Or sometimes just like, this is the right pattern, this is the right message, and you give it to someone who is like completely irrelevant to the message. So when we are doing any sort of promotion or tips or education, these are the three kind of aspects we look through to make sure, hey, we are really careful on what we show to people because the attention is limited on our user. And like, especially the world is moving so fast, people are so busy. Mm. And as soon as you kind of like run out their energy or run out their attention, it's really hard to convince people to give you more. So we always kind of err on the, you can say, more conservative side to start. And then we start to expand to, you know, different audience, different level of user, and different use case when we do this more.